questions around bumper repair, plastic repair, and we've got some great content on our website as far as how we're doing one-sided and two-sided repairs. But with the increased popularity of plastic welding, a common question that comes up is, how do I cosmetically finish the surface after I've done my plastic welding? What product do I use? You know, how do I prep that? So we're gonna talk a little bit about that real quick as far as how we're gonna prep that surface. And what I have here is a stepped out repair to sort of illustrate this, right? So one of the things we wanna make sure that we're using when we're doing our plastic repairs is a quality epoxy product that's designed for bumper repair. Some of the concerns with a polyester type material that is being put on bumpers to do a repair is that they don't stay flexible for the life of the actual vehicle. Meaning they dry out over time, they actually start to shrink, they don't perform as well in cold or hot climates and could lead to delamination or cracking, right? So we stress the importance of cosmetically, if we're gonna finish it, we're using our 5887 Easy Sand Repair material to do this. Now, along with that, we wanna make sure that we're using our polyolefin adhesion promoter. Now, what this is a surface preparation and gets the surface ready to properly adhere the cosmetic repair material to the surface, meaning it creates almost like little fingers that will bite into the surface and then have something sticking up for the material to actually sit in. Now, along this lines of how do I wet it out and what do I do, what we're looking for is one wet coat. We're gonna put in our material so that we're actually getting our repair done. And then another common question that comes up is, if I have to reapply a second coat, do I need to reuse or reapply the polyolefin adhesion promoter? And the answer is yes. Because again, after we do our sanding procedure and we've feathered this out, we've now cut back into this raw material again, and we wanna prep that surface to properly adhere our bumper repair material too. Once we have our initial sand out clean and we're ready to put on our second coat, we'll give this another spray. We're looking for just one wet coat. And what this looks like, guys, is we're just trying to wet the surface. We don't wanna bury it. If you put too much on, it'll actually do the reverse. It won't give you any adhesion and the material will pull off. If you don't happen to put adhesion promoter on, you run the risk of it actually rolling back as you're sanding it. So if this is a common problem that you're running into and you're saying, man, I don't use your material because it rolls back on the bumper as I'm sanding it, my next question would be, are you sure that you're putting on an adhesion promoter prior to this so that we're getting a really nice, good feather transition edge? And then when we prime it and paint it, the repair disappears and it looks like it did originally. So for more information on this and other plastic repair related topics, please visit us at our 3M Collision Repair Academy. The link to that is in the description below. Also, check out our other videos here on YouTube. Hit subscribe and the notification bell in the corner. That way you get the most up-to-date information as we release it so that you're current with the industry's best practices and 3M recommendations. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And if you want, comment in the section below. Thanks for watching this video and I'll see you next time.